what I'm talking about.
Wait!
Okay, now, from the beginning.
Let's rock and roll, gentlemen. That is simply sensational.
Holy cow!
Wow! Oh!
Very nice.
Absolutely brilliant.
I just think it's fantastic to be here witnessing Hero CPL.
It's a sea of yellow.
Magnificent.
This is absolutely stunning.
Goodness me.
Astounding.
Time to have another party here in Guyana. Hashtag biggest all.
This is your News Source Evening Bulletin for today, Friday, the 2nd day of September in the year 2022. I'm Gordon Mosley reporting, and here's what we're tracking tonight. Promising a better future for Indigenous citizens and their communities, President Irfan Ali last evening said there will be a greater inclusion for the country's Indigenous people in the nation's development. Delivering the feature address at the celebration of the start of Armenian Heritage Month, the President said the groundwork has already been laid for the Indigenous prosperity. He explained that all Guyanese, regardless of how they look or where they're from, are entitled to the same treatment and opportunities.
Tonight, I reassure every member of our Indigenous community that we stand strongly with you in ensuring that our development path, in ensuring that creating the pathway to prosperity will include you, every one of you, every single family, every single region in our Indigenous community, whether it's in the riverine area, whether it's on the hill or in the valleys, we will find you, we'll work with you, and we will move you together as we build a country of prosperity for every single family.
President Ali admitted that there is a development gap between the hinterland and coastland regions. He assured, however, that his government will close that gap.
We will make the investment to give you the bandwidth, to give you online education. And I'm saying this tonight, as I said in Region 9, every single Amerindian with the qualification that want to be trained as a nurse, as a teacher, as a dental technician, as a medical worker, I'm saying to you now, we are committing that we as a government will train every single one of you. Come forward. We will provide the opportunity. We will provide the money. We will provide the environment. And we will give you that opportunity.
The president also said the government is working to secure the rights of Indigenous peoples as well as to expand their freedoms. He said the government will also ensure home ownership for Indigenous residents by providing part funding and promise to work with banks to ensure low interest rates.
I am not in the business of talking the talk. We are in the business of moving with you. We are not speaking from above you. We are not speaking from beneath you. We are speaking with you, side by side, together, advancing the work.
This year's Amerindian Heritage Month is being observed under the theme celebrating our traditional culture while embracing One Guyana. More news when we return in just a moment.
Man, I've been getting this feeling lately. I don't know where it's coming from. I got this itch to win and win big, and I got to scratch it. Activate, scratch, win big with GTT's blazing hot summer promotion, which runs from July 1st to September 30th. Activate a data plan or bundle and receive a link to your digital scratch card every Saturday. Tap the link, scratch, and you can be a winner of one of our amazing prizes of electric bikes, TVs, laptops, tablets, food vouchers, and so much more. It's gonna be a blazing hot summer with GTT's scratch and win promotion.
Are you looking for the best high school education at affordable fees? then register your child today at the VYC Academy. Now enroll in grade 7 and 8 students for the 2022-2023 academic year. VYC Academy, achieving academic excellence. For more information, call us on 227-1013 or WhatsApp us on 613-4806.
Office Max, we're all about customer satisfaction. Whether it's clothing and shoes for the ladies, gents, and kids, or for the latest electronics or hardware appliance, we're always thinking of satisfying you, our dear customers. Now you can shop online at www.giftlandofficemax.com or visit us at the Giftland Mall, where we're happy to serve each and every one of you.
Like Oculus Quest 2, Mini 2 Drone, Nintendo Switch, and many more top gaming prizes. Check below for our details.
English Guyanese-born jurist Justice Louise Blenman today vowed to improve the Belizean justice system, moments after she was sworn in as the Chief Justice of Belize.
I shall use my best efforts to improve the administration of justice in Belize. I am committed to ensuring that the most important court users, namely the litigants, are provided with easy access to justice that is fair, independent, and efficient.
The newly appointed Chief Justice of Belize, who is the first woman to be confirmed in that position, warned that unless the court system works effectively and efficiently, investors would be slow to go to Belize. As such, she pledged to work to improve the effectiveness and efficiency of the justice system in the country.
I am looking forward to contributing significantly to the reforms of the justice system, which are aimed at improving the quality and timeliness of delivery of justice in Belize.
The new Chief Justice of Belize took her oath in the presence of the Governor General, the Minister of Foreign Affairs, and the former President of the Caribbean Court of Justice, and among other dignitaries, family, and friends. Chief Justice Blenman said she's more than honored to serve the people of Belize and will work to uphold the rule of law.
It is with humility, but with the greatest pleasure, that I stand here today, having just sworn the oath of office of Chief Justice. It is an honor to be appointed as Chief Justice of Belize. I have undertaken to execute my duties without fear or favor, ill will, or affection, in an efficient and effective manner.
The newly appointed Chief Justice said it is important for the constitutional rights of persons to be protected and enforced. Justice Blenman's wealth of experience spans over 34 years, with 15 years as an attorney serving mainly in the public bars in Guyana and St. Lucia, including as a Solicitor General of St. Lucia.
My total 22 years of public service allowed me to view the reforms and participate in them closer. I intend to willingly share my experience and expertise with the people of Belize. I am of the firm view that the Caribbean is stronger together, and we must continue to share our experiences and expertise with each other.
She also served as a judge on the Eastern Caribbean Court. She has credited her success to the Almighty God, her immediate family, and support and mentorship that she received from Senior Guyanese Counsel Rex McKay and former Guyanese Chancellor of the Judiciary, the late Justice Kate Messiah. The Chief Executive Officer of the International Decade for People of African Descent Assembly Guyana, Olive Sampson, has referred to Culture Minister Charles Ramson Jr. to the Ministry of Finance for all of the financial information that he has requested from the organization. In a response to the Culture Minister's letter seeking financial documents, the CEO of the group said not only was a comprehensive audit of the organization's finances done for the period 2018 to 2021, but all financial records for that period were submitted to the Central Internal Audit Unit of the Ministry of Finance. She told the Culture Minister that he may be unfamiliar with the reference audit report, which was done under the purview of the Ministry of Finance and which established that the organization's disbursement of funds was proper and without cause for reprimand. She said the findings of the audit from 2018 to 2021 provided guidance on minor changes to internal processes that have since been implemented. Ramson, in his letter to the organization earlier this week, said his request was as a result of recent disclosures, publications, and public statements. But the IPANG CEO said the organization's operation has been above par and noted that the organization agrees and commits to accountability for every cent allocated to them from any source. It was explained that the only period for which receipts and disbursement by the organization have not been audited is from the 1st of January 2022 to present. And she noted that they are aware of the legal provisions for the financial exposures and audits of entities such as IPANG. However, she noted that further demonstration of the group's commitment to accountability, they are prepared in this instance to submit the relevant records to an independent auditor, although statutorily the period is not due for an audit. According to the CEO, the group stands ready to engage the appropriate government agency to mutually agree on such an independent auditor and the necessary terms of reference for the period January 1st, 2022 to present. The organization has been receiving support funding from the government of Guyana since 2018. Ramson's letter to the group was sent exactly 1 week after the organization's chairman of its coordinating council, Vincent Alexander, sent a letter from his attorney to the vice president, notifying the vice president of his intention to file legal proceedings against him for statements that he made against Alexander and his role in the organization and its finances. Alexander has demanded an apology from the vice president and compensation to the tune of $50 million.
Doors and windows, Republic. Rooms and more, Republic. A brand new rug on the floor. Come to Republic, come to Republic. Whatever you need, you got it. Come to and get your mortgage. Live the dream with Republic.
95 to 100% financing, 50% waive off negotiation fees, plus one lucky person gets their mortgage paid in full. Turn someday into today. Talk to Republic Bank about your low-cost mortgage today.
Team Rodney and 592 Lounge presents
Ailita
with Mr. Killer live in concert, doing all his big hit songs. With music by Deli Ranks, DJ Hell, DJ Roti, DJ Zaya, and DJ Aquilo. Saturday, September 24th at McKenzie's Port Club Ground. 314 Greenheart Street, Linden, Guyana. It's Ailita with Mr. Killer live.
Hey yo, GT Massive, this is Double M. Ola, hear me out. Right now it's all about the Marshall Super Concert, October 1st. Right here, it's cricket, it's carnival, it's soca in Guyana. Hey! Ah!
One of Guyana's longest-serving ministers of foreign affairs, Rashley Jackson, passed away last evening here in Georgetown. He was 93 years old. The former foreign minister, who served in the post from 1978 to 1990, was well respected in the foreign diplomacy community and internationally recognized. He assisted the present and past governments on issues related to Guyana's borders. In a statement last evening, the Minister of Foreign Affairs said Rashley Jackson's contribution to the foundation and implementation of Guyana's foreign policy is the legacy of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. The ministry said he was held in high esteem locally and internationally, and will always be remembered for his fight to preserve Guyana's sovereignty and territorial integrity. The People's National Congress Reform, in a statement last evening, said it was saddened by the passing of Mr. Jackson. According to the party, his intellect was unsurpassed and his patriotism was unshakable. The opposition party said the greatest tribute to Rashley Jackson would be to build a better country for all to live in peace, prosperity, and harmony. Rashley Jackson was the recipient of Guyana's second highest national award, the Order of Roraima. Four men were arrested by the Customs Anti-Narcotics Unit on Thursday in Vryslust after more than 3 pounds of foreign marijuana were found in their possession. According to a statement from KANU, KANU ranks intercepted a car with the four men, and a search of the vehicle unearthed the illegal substance. KANU said the seized marijuana carries a street value of more than $2.8 million. The four suspects were identified as Dudnot Bangwandin, Kevin Ramgulam, Mark Barton, and Irwin Chappell. Investigations into the Thursday bust are ongoing. Let's tell you now that a 37-bed unit has been set up at the Infectious Disease Hospital at Liliendal to treat identified and suspected cases of monkeypox. Even as the Ministry of Health works along with the Pan American Health Organization to source vaccine and antiretroviral medication to treat infected persons. Health officials made those revelations today during a forum designed to educate news editors and journalists on monkeypox and the steps being taken by the Ministry of Health to boost its capacity to effectively combat the virus. In late August, Guyana recorded its first two isolated cases of monkeypox in Region 4. However, globally, there are approximately 51,000 cases, of which 28,000 cases could be found in the Americas. Monkeypox was declared a public health emergency by the WHO back in July. In his address this morning, Minister of Health Dr. Frank Anthony said the Ministry of Health is working with PAHO to source the monkeypox vaccine at a reasonable price.
These vaccines can be for both pre-exposure prophylaxis and post-exposure prophylaxis. So we'll be working with PAHO, and we're assured that by the end of this month that we'll be able to get some of those vaccines into country. But I want you to understand how scarce these things are. Because if you got one company in the world that is manufacturing this, and everybody trying to get the same vaccine, you can understand the mad scramble that is happening.
The health minister said already a number of health specialists have been trained to test, detect, and treat the virus.
Here in Guyana, PAHO has helped us to build that capacity because they arrange for our technical staff to go and have training by a PAHO specialized team in Jamaica. And then they came back and they trained a lot of people in our country. So we have the capability, we have trained people, we are able to make these diagnoses. Guidelines and so forth, we have been able to work on them, and so these things are important.
Infectious disease specialist at the Georgetown Hospital, Dr. Shamiza Shaw, said with a core group of medical personnel already trained, the health ministry is also working to get antiretroviral medication to treat symptomatic cases of monkeypox. Dr. Shaw also explained that only high-risk persons, such as healthcare workers, will be vaccinated against the virus. She said there will be no mass vaccination against monkeypox. The transmission of a monkeypox is through close contact with an infected person. Once infected, the incubation period can last from 7 to 21 days. Before the appearance of lesions, infected persons can experience symptoms like myalgia, swollen lymph nodes, swelling in the neck, and headaches.
At Giftland Office Max, we're all about customer satisfaction. Whether it's clothing and shoes for the ladies, gents, and kids, or for the latest electronics or hardware appliance, we're always thinking of satisfying you, our dear customers. Now you can shop online at www.giftlandofficemax.com or visit us at the Giftland Mall, where we're happy to serve each and every one of you.
Are you looking for the best high school education at affordable fees? Then register your child today at the VYC Academy. Now enroll in grade 7 and 8 students for the 2022-2023 academic year. VYC Academy, achieving academic excellence. For more information, call us on 227-1013 or WhatsApp us on 613-4806.
Be on the road for the Cricket Carnival 2022 with the big-ass costume bands, Melange, powered by Orlando Carnival Downtown, Palm Court Amazonia Brazilian Band, Kayap by the Ministry of Amerindian Affairs, Hit West Side Wild West Band, Hits and Gems, Genesis and Utopia Band, and the Pulse Warriors. More bands, more bacchanal, more fun. Log on now to www.cricketcarnival592.com to choose your costume band, and let's party through the streets of Georgetown. On October 2nd. Doi doi.
Doors and windows,
Republic.
Rooms and more,
Republic.
A brand new rug on the floor. Come to Republic. Come to Republic. Whatever you need, you got it. Come to and get your mortgage. Live the dream with Republic.
95 to 100% financing, 50% waive off negotiation fees, plus one lucky person gets their mortgage paid in full. Turn someday into today. Talk to Republic Bank about your low-cost mortgage today.
Get in the game with Buster. Win a full gaming setup, Xbox X, gaming chair, gaming speaker and headset, or any of over 60 weekly prizes like Oculus Quest 2, Mini 2 Drone, Nintendo Switch, and many more top gaming prizes. Check below for details.
Fuel it up and drive, Super 95. Tune up, fuel it up and drive, Super 95. Tune up. Protect your fuel system, boy. High mileage and performance, boy.
Guy Oil's Super 95 gasoline gives you more reasons to drive and is available at 56 service stations nationwide. For affordable price, high performance, and high mileage, choose Guyol's Super 95 gasoline.
Fuel it up and drive!
Across the region tonight, Argentina's Vice President Cristina Fernandez de Kirchner escaped unharmed yesterday after a man fired a loaded gun at her that failed to go off inches from her head. The attack, which the economy minister called an assassination attempt, comes at a time of acute political and social frictions inside Argentina. It happened as the vice president stepped out of a car outside her Buenos Aires home, where hundreds of supporters had gathered. Video footage showed a man holding a pistol next to her head. The president of Argentina, Alberto Fernandez, said the gun had been loaded with five bullets. The suspect, who the authorities identified as a 35-year-old man of Brazilian origin, was quickly arrested by the police and the weapon seized. The vice president is a former president of Argentina. The governments of Trinidad and Tobago and Jamaica have signed the MOU to establish a trade complaints mechanism between the two countries in an effort to foster better relations. A statement from the Trade Ministry in Trinidad said the event took place during a bilateral meeting of the heads of government of the two countries on Monday. It said it was a result of the efforts and strong desire of the prime ministers of Trinidad and Jamaica to maintain and deepen relations. A statement said the establishment of the mechanism represents a significant milestone and provides an avenue for the expeditious resolution of trade complaints between the two countries. The Ministry of Trade also noted that Jamaica is a significant trading partner with Trinidad and Tobago, adding that both countries trade in over 1 billion Trinidad and Tobago dollars of products each year, and both have significant investments in each other's country. And finally tonight, international news. FBI agents found dozens of empty folders marked as classified during a search of Donald Trump's home last month, a court document shows. The document made public by a Florida court provides an inventory of the contents of 33 boxes recovered from the former president's Mar-a-Lago estate. It also shows top secret files were recovered from his personal office. Mr. Trump, who is being investigated over his handling of classified records, denies any wrongdoing. Previous court filings have confirmed the ex-president held classified records in storage areas at Mar-a-Lago. But the document unsealed on Friday showed dozens of files were found in Mr. Trump's office. Among the items recovered from that room during the unprecedented 8th of August search were 3 documents marked confidential, 17 documents marked secret, 7 documents marked top secret, 43 empty folders with classified banners, and 28 folders labeled return to staff secretary, military aid. U.S. presidents must transfer all of their documents and emails to the National Archives. The Justice Department is looking into whether Mr. Trump improperly handled records by taking them from the White House to his Mar-a-Lago estate after he left office in January 2021. And that's your News Source Evening Bulletin for tonight and this week. I'm Gordon Mosley reporting and encouraging you to stay safe.